We would like to thank our friends over at Simply Safe for sponsoring today's video. If you use our custom URL, which is down below, you can get 30% off your security system and get a free camera. But more on that here in a few minutes.
Hey guys, welcome back. So today we're out at the range with the 7.5 FK PSD pistol. And in our last video, we showed you how this handgun fired the extremely powerful 7.5 FK and also came with a 10 millimeter barrel, which would allow you to shoot it a little bit more affordably and with ammunition you can find a little bit more readily. Now, I also want to address really quickly at the beginning of the video that many in the comments section brought up the 9x25 Dillon and said, well, how does it stack up to the 7.5 FK? I don't know. I don't own one. Matter of fact, I went out and tried to find a barrel for any of my guns in 9x25 Dillon and came up empty-handed. So it's not really a apples-to-apples comparison. This is a production pistol. This is production ammo. You can order it online and have it delivered to your house, and this you can have delivered to your FFL. So anyway, when I was in Germany, I had a chance to see the gun in all three calibers. This was several years ago before it came to the US market. And when I was there, they had it in a prototype state in 9mm for us to shoot. And it was absolutely amazing. It was just, I mean, it's a big handgun. It's designed for really heavy calibers like the 7.5 FK and full power 10mm. But in 9mm, it was just a pussycat and very pleasant to shoot. Well, the owner of the company was somewhat reluctant to make it 9mm because that's not what the gun's made for. It's made for big, bold calibers. So with pressure from Rob Pincus and a few other folks in the industry, he actually brought the 9mm conversion kits to the United States. They're here now, and I have one to show you so we can tame the beast and detune it to 9mm for extremely cheap shooting when you don't want to chew up and expend your 7.5 FK. So let's start off shooting a few rounds out of the 7.5 FK. It's such a pleasant caliber to shoot in this handgun, despite the fact in our last video, I was tearing up my AR-400 steel plates with this round. It's that powerful. Those plates are rated for 357 Magnum, 44 Magnum, which doesn't do anything to those AR-400 plates. This thing was putting dents in it. All right, so let's do a few rounds on my challenge targets that I don't want to bang up too bad. Let's jump over and talk about the 9mm. Wow, what a pleasant shooting handgun, despite the fact that it's firing that extremely powerful caliber for a handgun that's self-loading anyway. All right, let's take a look at the 9mm. Conversion kit for the PSD pistol.
If you guys are anything like me, you've probably put off getting a home security system because it's just an overwhelming process to go through, or perhaps you didn't want a complete stranger coming into your house and setting up your security system. That's what I had the biggest problem with. I didn't want a stranger in my house setting up a security system. But even then, when I was looking at security systems online, there's so many different choices out there, I didn't know what would be a good choice. And that's where Simply Safe comes in. Simply Safe, you can easily configure your system on their website and place your order, or you can order right over the phone. You can bring up their website, and if you want to do it the old-fashioned way, that option does exist. You can custom configure your system for your own unique house and the setup that you would need for that house. So as you can see in front of me, there's a bunch of different sensors. You have everything from cameras that can be accessed remotely. You have carbon monoxide sensors, smoke sensors, glass breakage sensors, window and door opening sensors, water sensors for the basement by your sump pump. Just about every type of sensor you can think of, Simply Safe offers that. Setting up each of the devices is easily accomplished with the handheld device that comes with the system. You would place this by your front door or the door that you use most to come in and out of your house. And you can arm the system and disarm it from this. You can also, of course, set up your system using this keypad, but also you can use your cell phone to arm and disarm your security system. So as you're coming up the driveway, you can turn your security system off. You don't have to wait to turn it off when you come in the house. Now, they do offer that 24/7 monitoring. We have that service. My wife forgot that I had set the alarm and she came home and accidentally tripped the alarm one day. And she sent me a text saying that she had accidentally tripped the alarm. And within seconds after getting her text, I got a phone call from the monitoring service for SimpliSafe. And they wanted to make sure I was safe. They asked me for my password. I gave that to them. And they just wanted to make sure that everything was okay. And when they determined that it was, that was the end of the call. But had I needed police to respond, they would have done so immediately. So if you guys would like to order your system, you can use the URL down below for 30% off, and it will also come with a free camera. That's a really good deal. So please check out simplisafe.com.
All right, guys, over here is my original 7.5 FK pistol that we opened the video with. It was originally sent to me with a 7.5 FK and 10 millimeter barrel. So when the 9 millimeter gun showed up, this is what I found in the box. Here you can see the pistol and four magazines, three held in reserve down below the handgun, one inserted into the handgun. The gun originally shipped with the 7.5 FK barrel and spring and magazine in it. I have since converted it to 9mm. We're not going to talk a whole lot about 7.5 FK in this video. And so it had the spare barrel over here, the recoil spring that's required for the 9mm. You have to swap out the 7.5 FK /10mm spring for a lighter 9mm spring. And then again, the extra magazines. So just like the other gun, I mean, guys, this is the same gun, obviously, as you can see here. It's the same handgun, just being in 7.5 FK and 9mm. And this honestly is probably going to appeal to a lot more shooters, because even though I love 10mm, it's still a relatively hard caliber to find sometimes. It's not exactly as popular as 9mm, obviously. So you're going to find 9mm everywhere, except for right now. It's the crunch of 2020 and people continue to panic buy guns and ammo. But in a normal market, in a normal world, 9mm is readily available and typically pretty darn affordable. So the biggest difference between the 9mm kit and the 10mm/7.5 FK, the 7.5 FK to 10mm is a simple barrel swap. To take it to 9mm, it's a barrel, recoil spring, and magazine swap. And that's because the 7.5 FK and 10mm use the same magazine and recoil spring. So they had to lighten the recoil spring. And I'll show you what that looks like here really quick. Yes, I'm wearing mittens because it's cold out here. I think I'm going to be able to show you once I get this out of there. All right. So, you can tell the 9mm recoil spring because it's yellow. The 10mm/7.5 FK has no color coding on it. The 9mm barrel's already in the gun. It uses the same weighted system to mitigate recoil, which there is none in 9mm. I won't say there is none. The gun moves, obviously, under recoil, but it is really, really, really muted. By far the softest 9mm I've ever shot. So that's what you swap out. Magazine, recoil spring, and barrel. Super simple to do. It's accomplished by a simple field strip. And if you know how to take apart a 1911 or a CZ75, that's not going to be very difficult for you at all. All right. With that being said, now this is a single action only pistol. It looks like a CZ75. It does come from the Czech Republic, but it is a single action only pistol with a very positive detent for a 1911 style safety. So if you wanted to carry this thing cocked and locked, this is one of the few pistols I would consider doing that with because of that very positive detent that's very reminiscent of the 1911. All right, guys, let's load up some 9mm ammunition and see how the tamed monster works with the putty 9mm. If you go back to our first video on the PSD pistol, we did a simple test. We wanted to see if the 10mm round would fit into the 7.5 FK and then vice versa. And what we found was the 7.5 FK would fit into the 10mm. Now, what would happen if you fired a 7.5 FK out of a 10mm barrel? In all likelihood, nothing catastrophic. It would just go pop, send the bullet down range, and you may have a stuck case in the chamber, but probably not. It would just fall right out. I'm not going to do it because I really don't want to do that to my PSD pistol. But then we tried to put the 10mm in the 7.5 FK barrel, and that would be a bit more of a problem, because if you tried to push a 10mm projectile down a 7.5mm barrel, that would cause a catastrophic failure, potentially. Well, fortunately, the 10mm would not chamber fully and seat fully, in the 7.5 FK barrel, so safe. Real quick, the 7.5 FK in the 9mm goes in exactly that far. Again, not even close. And yeah, even if you were to get it in there, once again, the 7.5 FK would most likely just go down the barrel and you'd have a split case or something. But anyway, so that we have that out of the way, I also wanted to talk about the magazines. So the 7.5 FK / 10mm mag is right here. And in my left pocket, I have a 9mm mag. So there are a couple of differences here. First of all, you'll notice the base plate. It's polymer on the 9mm mag, steel on the 7.5 FK / 10mm. And you'll notice the 7.5 FK / 10mm is a very long magazine. An Uplula mag loader will not work on this magazine. If you look at the 9mm, it's more narrow, the actual metal, and this is a Megar magazine, high quality mag. And then on the back of it, you have a polymer spacer to take up that slop that would otherwise be in there because of the shorter length of the 9mm magazine. So those are the basic differences between the 7.5 FK mag / 10mm versus the 9mm, that little polymer piece on the back and the shorter overall length. Sadly, this polymer piece on the back comes up high enough that once again, we're not able to use an Uplula magazine loader. The 9mm holds 17 rounds. Getting that 17th round in there can be extremely challenging, especially on new magazines. 16 rounds in the 7.5 FK, and it kind of broke in to the point where getting that 16th round in there was no real problem. All right, so insert some 124 grain Federal into the FK. Let's go ahead and charge the pistol. Now, as I've pointed out before, I have the iron sights on this one. I don't have a red dot sight, but it has the plate up here for a red dot sight. And we have these little cocking charging ears on the rear of the slide. That's because the slide rides internal to the frame and it has very little to grab a hold of, much like a CZ-75 pistol. So they put these little tabs on here, which are screws that are textured, so you can grab a hold of it and pull it to the rear. And we've seen similar things done like that on, say, the HK BP9. It has polymer tabs back there for you to grab a hold of. All right, so do we have a round chambered? Yes, we do. And watch what a pussycat this is. Uh-oh, one stovepipe with the 124 grain stuff. Let's see if that continues. Now keep in mind, guys, this gun was not designed to shoot 9mm. As we got to the bottom of the magazine, the problems seemed to go away. Let's see if it happens again. Again, this is just standard Federal 124 grain ball. We would like to thank our friends over at Federal for sending us the ammunition free of charge. That help greatly supports the channel. All right, perfect. So, the magazine grabbed a hold of my mitten. Let go. So anyway, that is literally the third magazine we've put through the gun in 9mm. Perhaps it was a little bit of a break-in period. Keep in mind, we're taking a hand cannon and detuning to shoot one of the, you know, most common and not all that powerful calibers, the 9mm. This thing has a lot of mass that has to reciprocate with that 9mm round. So there's no, I understood why the owner didn't want to take it, detune it all the way down to 9mm, because I really thought they're going to have to change the weight of that little spacer in there and things like that. Surprisingly, they got it to work with the barrel, the spring, and the magazine. So let's shoot some more with it and see if we run into more issues or if the gun's just going to break in here for us this afternoon and run the regular old 9mm ball for us. We have a limited selection of 9mm ammunition, and we're running short of 9mm ammunition, but we do have some old 115 grain Federal ball. You can see it's a little bit kind of grungy looking. It's not shiny and new. It's been sitting in the garage for quite a while. Had to dig deep to find it. Let's see how it works with the 115 grain stuff. Now, I will go ahead and hazard a guess and say if you limp wrist this gun at all, you don't hold on to it tight, and don't give it something to operate off of, you're probably gonna run into malfunctions. So I'm gonna make sure I get a good, nice, tight grip on it and not hold it rather loosely and see how she functions with the 115 grain stuff. I think this is like the fourth magazine we've put through the gun today. All 16 rounds without issue. Yeah, I think we were just having some issues there because possibly we just needed to work her in a little bit. Got another magazine of 16 rounds of 115 grain ball. After this, we're gonna stop shooting full magazines to conserve ammunition. Jeez, that thing is smooth. And she ran just fine with the 115 grain stuff. In the last take, I may have misspoke and said the 9mm magazines took 16 rounds. I'm thinking in terms of 7.5 FK, the 9mm take 17 rounds in the magazine. Now we have, we're at this point using partial boxes of ammunition that we found. I have 13 rounds of 115 grain ball that's left over from those partial boxes. I'm gonna fire out of this magazine. And the other magazine, we're gonna use the Remington ammunition. And we were only able, as hard as we could try, to get 16 rounds into the 17 round magazine. So maybe that's just a break-in thing for the magazine, I don't know. But in this cold weather, we simply could not get that 17th round in there without the assistance of an Uplula. All right, 13 rounds of 115 grain Federale. Flawless function there. This is the Remington stuff. It looks like 115 grain, is that right? Yeah, 115 grain Remington. Let's see how this stuff, it almost looks like 380 that round. The way it's shaped, let's see how she works. Flawless function, no more malfunctions. It thinks there was just that third magazine we put through it. That was the first time, that third magazine where we had the malfunctions in the beginning. That was the first full magazine we had put through the gun. So that was another full magazine, at least as full as we could get it with 16 rounds. And she's chugging right along. And again, it's such a pussycat to shoot. It's actually fun to shoot this big old hoss of a handgun in 9mm. But if I was gonna take it into the field, I'd definitely go with 10mm or 7.5 FK, especially if I was gonna hunt with it or something like that. All right, so we have a magazine that we've filled as full as we can get. It may be 16 or 17 rounds, we weren't counting. We just loaded it until it stopped taking rounds and we pressed and pressed and pressed and couldn't get another round in there, so we'll find out how many are in there. But after this, we're just gonna go to shooting 10, maybe 15 rounds per magazine, again, to conserve ammunition. So, let's see how she does. I love how I keep doing that. All right, magazine inserted. Let's see how she functions. That was 17 rounds, okay? Not bad. Let's fire off the next magazine, which only has 15 rounds loaded of the 124 grain Federal. And then let's take a look at the trigger reset and see what that looks like here for the PSD pistol. Let's go ahead and make sure it's cocked. Gonna, if you watch my finger, take up the slack, hit a shelf, press, click, and no over travel that I can detect at all. Reset the pistol here really quick. I'm gonna drop the magazine out because it's gonna make it a little bit easier. Okay, once again, take up the slack, you hit a shelf, click, no over travel. Reset is right there, and that's full release. So you have to let that trigger out a little ways before the reset occurs. All right, shelf, break, reset, right there, full release. All right, let's do a little bit of work with the falling targets and we'll move over to the man size target. Now these little sights are interesting. I'll get a shot for you guys. But they're very small and precise. So you hear that harmonic ring, that's when you hit them in the lungs. So, yeah, very, very comfortable, easy to pistol to shoot. We're about 15 yards from the target. And this one I think is gonna be 15 rounds. God, I love this pistol. Yeah, she's a sweetheart. As I mentioned earlier in the video, if you'd like to learn more about the recoil system of this handgun, please refer to our original video about the PSD pistol. I get into more detail about how the recoil attenuating system works in the handgun, which is that heavyweight underneath the barrel. The gun obviously was designed to fire the hot rod 7.5 FK round, but the fact that we now have 10mm and 9mm conversions, that's pretty solid. The gun, we fired about 300 rounds this afternoon. We had some issues right out of the gate with one of the first magazines that we put through the gun. After that, we had no more failures of any kind. We're going to include that footage because it's fair. That's what we do here on the channel. Those were the malfunctions we encountered, and it just happened at the very beginning. I made sure that I had a tight grip on the pistol after that, and the malfunctions stopped happening. We tried three different types of ammunition, the 124 grain Federal, 115 grain Federal, and 115 grain Remington. And so the gun seems to work actually pretty darn well as a 9mm, better than I really thought it would work, given the fact that it has that big heavy barrel weight and stuff like that, or the recoil attenuating weight that's underneath the barrel. I'm surprised it even uses that, to be honest with you, but they made it work, and I think they made it work reasonably well. The gun does retail for $1,650, and I believe that comes with two calibers, and then you would have to request that third caliber, so you can either order it as a 7.5 FK in 9mm or a 7.5 FK in a 10mm. What the price is for the extra barrel or the 9mm conversion kit, I don't know, but you can find out more information by going to the FK BRNO website. Thanks to YouTube's rules, I can't post that link in the video description below because they would ban my channel. So you'll just have to do some Google foo. I don't think you're going to see these on the shelves of too many dealers, at least I haven't, but picking it up directly from FK and having it shipped to your dealer is probably the best way to go, and that's where you're also going to find the 7.5 FK ammunition. So what I think of the gun, absolutely love it. It's a great pistol. I love the 7.5 FK because of how powerful it is. I really love the ability to shoot 10mm because I actually shoot that quite often. And now with the 9mm, I'll be shooting it a whole lot more. Guys, thank you for supporting the channel. If you would like to continue to have honest, unbiased, as humanly possible videos like this one, please consider supporting us over on Patreon. There you'll get behind the scenes information, early access to videos, and direct access to me to answer questions or anything like that that crop up. I focus all of my attention on taking care of our Patreons. And also, if you'd like to support us here on YouTube, that's another option for you. Underneath the video player you're watching right now, there's a little join button. Click that join button, and you can support us right here on YouTube in the age of mostly being demonetized by YouTube because we talk about things like guns. And last but not least, please swing by and check out coppercustom.com. Guys, thank you for 12 years of support. We'll talk to you guys soon.